Lantern jellies blocked Merrin's path. Although the creatures could be deadly to the touch, they were very shy, and even avoided each other's light. Peered through the windows of the houses, wondering if a Merrow girl once lived there, and if her father had sung her lullabies about the world above. Discovered two glowing lights amidst the scraps of an old Fomori machine. She attached them to the front of the submarine's hull, hoping they would help guide her on her journey. Color darted through the shadows. Was that a Merrow maiden swimming through the ruins? Merrin tried to speak to her, but the Merrow raced away. Razor-quilled pufferfish was not a direct threat, but it steadfastly refused to move out of the way. Swirl in the water tugged at Merrin's sob. Was this a Tyne vortex? Where might it lead? At last, the Merrow Maiden stopped. Merrin called to her. Please wait. I'm only trying to find my father. The Merrow looked at her for a long moment, then stirred the water with her hands, forming a ghostly image. It was the sunken ship graveyard known as Skeleton Reef. Could her father be trapped there? The Merrow pointed the way to go, and Merrin thanked her. Before she turned to go, Merrin asked the Merrow her name.
Call me Kara, she said. Another girl once called me that, years ago. She said it means friend.
Thank you.
Merrin picked up a fragment of a Fomori Sentinel's hull. She hammered it into the wall of her own submarine, making it more resistant to damage. Merrin found a tiny but powerful turbine. She connected it to a ball joint on the submarine's tail. The seahorse was poking at a glass wall. Such a strange creature, Merrin thought. She wished she could understand what it wanted.
Thank you. Thank you.